The R-36 Eruptor is a beast. When it comes to facing the Terminids, it snipes bug holes and spore towers, it one-shots most bugs, deals a ton of splash damage, and this is hands down the best primary weapon for the Chargers. But what happens when we take this thing across the galaxy to the Automatons? Is it just as effective? And what is the best way to actually use this gun versus the bots? Dr. Pooplove here, and let's discuss. Now, I went in more depth on the stats for the Eruptor in my video showing how to use this gun versus the bugs. So I won't go in too much depth on the stats here, but to recap, this thing has a very high explosive and medium armor penetrating damage that is offset by a lower capacity, higher recoil, and a very slow rate of fire. This is a bolt action rifle, so every shot has to be loaded up, and something that will factor in a lot against the bots is the slow rotation. But we will talk about that. Now, for utility, just like the bug missions, this is excellent. You can hit the factory vents and take them out with one shot. In fact, you can snipe them from a distance. You can also use it to take the doors off for these side objectives with only one shot. You can also take out the illegal broadcasts in one shot. Well, as long as you don't hit this thing. Aim for the base of the tower to one-shot it. Now, the Eruptor does have limited range. Bullets will actually explode at around 125 meters, so you can't shoot anything beyond that. An excellent way to make sure that you are in range is to mark your target. Doing so will reveal the number of meters that this is away from you, and it will let you know whether you're wasting a bullet or not. But how is this thing versus actual combat against the bots? Well, it's pretty good, but it does have some downsides. Firstly, in general, automaton combat is more at range, which is good for this gun, as close combat can result in you blowing yourself up. The scope is a great option here for making sure to line up your shots against those targets at range. Now, versus the basic bots, this will one-shot them all, although it can feel like a waste to take just one of these out, so I tend to use my secondary weapon for single guys when I can, and I try to use the splash damage when there are multiple clumped up together. Now, because these guys are skinny, well, it can be easy to actually miss them. The splash damage on this thing is good though, so if you want, you can just hit the general ground below them instead to avoid having to be super precise and risking missing completely. Now, versus the berserkers, this seems to take about two shots, which can still feel pretty hard, especially if they are rushing you. This gun does have stun though, which will help keep them at bay. But given the low reload speed, you may end up having to spend more time than you would like dodging them. For striders though, this will one-shot them from the front due to the explosive damage. It's not always consistent though, it may take two shots, but I find that crotch shots tend to be pretty reliable rather than going for the main faceplate, or again shooting the ground next to them seems to take them out pretty reliably with the splash damage. Versus devastators, this thing will go down in one headshot. But even if you miss and you hit something else, that is okay, because a second shot should do the trick. Shielded devastators, you can hit the shields directly and still do damage because of the explosive splash damage. In this case though, if you're only hitting the shield, it will be about three shots. Depending on the splash damage though, it could take something like four shots if you're just hitting the shield. But of course, you can and should try to just get an angle on their head. Now, the Eruptor is also pretty good versus the gunships, which will take them out in two shots to the underside. You just have to watch out for kind of the edges where there seems to be heavy armor, because it won't penetrate that. Dropships, this is not going to be able to take them down, but you can fire at the enemies that they're dropping in order to get some splash damage and kill them before they are even dropped. Now, for the Hulks, this one isn't that great. The front weak spot doesn't seem to get triggered here, and there doesn't seem to be any reliable way to let the explosion kind of creep around and get them from the back. So you will be left needing to go around and getting the vent. And because of the time it takes to load each bolt, it can be a bit frustrating trying to take this Hulk down quickly with this thing. And versus the factory strider, you can damage this a bit in the eye, but I don't really know how many bullets it will take, because I couldn't survive long enough with only using the Eruptor to take it out. All I know is the answer is it's too many bullets. Unless someone knows of a better weak spot that you can get to, I think you're going to want to use heavy armor penetration for this guy.
Now, for shredder tanks, this will dish out damage to the top of it, similar to the Scorcher, where the explosive damage will trigger that weak spot. However, it does seem to take a good number of shots, and given the slow fire rate and reload, this is not very efficient, and it's pretty slow. And because of this, it allows a lot of time for other bots to ship rockets up your ass. It's actually a similar thing with the Annihilator tanks, where you can immobilize it by shooting the tracks, and going for the vent, even with inaccurate splash damage, will work. But again, it takes a lot of time with all the reloading that you're gonna get a rocket up your ass. And with the rocket turrets, you can also use the splash damage or the vents, but after one shot, this tends to rotate towards you before you can get your subsequent shots in. And because you can't fire fast enough, it's gonna take a while. Rocket up your ass. This aspect alone does make it hard to recommend this gun over the Scorcher, which makes much quicker work of these very tough enemies. And this gets me to another major downside versus the bots, and that is the slow rotation speed. While this thing can dish out good damage on the bots, the heavy and slow rotation speed means it can take a while to line up your shot. In that process, you can end up getting blasted, which can be a bit frustrating. Of course, this gun would probably be too strong if you could snap right on target, but this is something that you will need to try to overcome. One thing to do this is just make sure to utilize cover to give yourself the time you need to line up your shots, and don't really stand out in the open reloading and trying to get another shot in. Use the time in between shots to stay mobile and take shots when they are ready. Another thing you can do is in your HUD settings, enable the reticle to be shown even when you're not aiming in. This will give you time to track your reticle and even line up your shots better so that you'll know when it's time to scope in for another shot. And so when I think about the Eruptor, one of the main things I think about is it's hard to recommend it when the Scorcher exists. The Scorcher just seems to be a lot more reliable versus most of the bots, and having that quicker fire rate and handling definitely makes things easier. Sure, it isn't as solid for utility, but since you'll need something strong for the Hulks and likely the tanks, it may not be necessary to have this when you're likely gonna want to use something like the Quasar cannon anyways, which can do all the same things for utility as the Eruptor. Besides its clear strength with utilities, the way the Eruptor truly shines is versus grouped up medium-sized enemies. Because of the significant splash damage and the high damage itself, it can take out those enemies much more efficiently than even something like the Scorcher. For that reason, I do still think it has a function and an importance against the bots. All in all though, the Eruptor is a solid gun, and it's honestly stronger than most when it comes to the bots. It's definitely something I would recommend over most guns in this game. I do see it as something viable to have with you, it's just maybe not the top performer. And that's totally okay. But what do you think? And what tips do you have for the Eruptor? Let me know in the comments. And I want to say a special thank you to my YouTube members for joining the Bowel Movement. But otherwise, so long, Pooper Troopers.